Hello, this is Matthias. Today's challenge is a real-world problem from a corporate financial consulting company which struggles to align these two datasets. It's a balance reconciliation problem. And in reality, of course, the datasets are more complicated. This is simplified. So we have more columns, we do have more dates than just one date. And third aspect as well, we do have to cope not only with duplicates in the second data set, but also in the first data set. So let's have a look at the expected result. So the amounts are aligned. And we do have here several empty fields. How does this come about? So let's have a look here for the 99.21. First example, it does show up in both data sets. So it's the date and the amount in both data sets available, means we take it over, bring in here the date, and the amount for base one and the amount for base two. That's easy. Now let's have a look at the 778.65. They do appear in both data sets, but only once in data set one and twice in data set two. Means for the first appearance, we do have a complete match. So it's a date, the amount for base one, and the amount for base two. Second appearance, second occurrence is only available in the second data set. So there's the date, an empty field for base one, and the amount for base two. So same for these 33,000s below. So three occurrences in base two, only one occurrence in base one, and two empty fields in base one. And it's the same the other way around. So for example, this 9798 is not available in data set two, means we have the date and the amount for base one and an empty field for base two. So we do have two challenges to solve. First, we have to align these two data sets by date and amount plus the number of occurrence. And then at the end, we have to make sure that this is the identical sorting order. So occurrence number one has to be before occurrence number two, and also here the sorting of the amounts should be identical. How to do this? Well, we do have already two tables built with Control T. So first one is plan, and the second one is ext-like extract. And because we do have already these two tables built, we can go directly to the data tab and import from table range to the Power Query editor. So here we are. I'll make this a bit bigger. And the first thing is we need to build an ID for the number of occurrence. So mark both columns and group by. So we group by date and base one. But we don't want to have a count. We want to have all rows. We name this here ID, because that's what we're going to build here. So this is now the complete table. And we don't need the complete table, so we get rid of this and replace it with date. Make it easier later on as well to build the second query. So around this date, we will now build an index with add index column table dot index column. The index column we will call ID. The index will start with 1 and will increase with 1. So basically we're done, but we only need the ID. So it down like this. Now we have here this. It's not really interesting because we always have 1. We can expand to new rows. Yeah, always 1 because we don't have any duplicates. So there's nothing really interesting to see here. But in the second one, we will see that it is important. And as I mentioned, also in plan, we do have duplicates. So easiest way to build ext is by duplicating plan, changing the name, and then changing source. So the table is called ext. Almost done. Only here we have to take care of this base 1, change it to base 2. And because we only have date here, no issues in the ID building. Let's see if we expand it. Yes, we do have with the duplicates an increase with the ID 1, 2 for 778. And for the 33,000s, we have 1, 2, 3. That's exactly what we wanted. Now let's merge these two queries. And we will do this with a separate query. So merge queries as new. So plan with ext. With control, we can now select all 3 columns in both queries. And we actually want to build a full outer. We want to have the data from both queries. But if we look at this, we'll see here at the end, the row with the data from ext. And if we look at this data, you can see here it's having 2 identical names like the plan query. So its date is identical, ID is identical. If we would expand this, and we need to expand it here, we would get the same name, and we want to avoid this. It's something we can do differently. So let's just come back here and change this to left outer. And we are going to combine 2 left outers. So here we are. We only need the base 2 info. And we do this without the prefix. There we are. That looks good. Now we have to do the same for the other side, for the extract. I will just copy here the code because that makes it easier to write it down. Just bring it in here completely identical and then change the order. So bringing extract to the beginning and change here this to plan. We are merging plan query to the extract data. Now let's do this. I change here the name. Oh. Okay, one more try. Yes. Oh, it's merged one just for clarity reasons. Yeah, have to expand this as well. This time it's space one we are getting. Good. So how to bring these two together by appending the query with itself? So go for merge one current. And that looks quite good. We only have to change here expanded plan with a step expanded extract. So these two now are appended. And this does include overlaps of these two merging steps. We get rid of this by just marking all columns and remove rows. We choose remove duplicates. So this leaves us with 15 rows. That's exactly what we need. The only thing which is now not good, that's the sorting. You see here there are nulls in both columns. So that means we will have difficulties to sort with the available columns. So let's introduce a helper column for the sorting. And that one I call sort. Not really important. And the thing is, we will combine the data from both base. So if base one is null, then we take base two. Else, take one. Simple as that. Now we have a nice column to sort on. And so let's start to sort. We have to sort according to the date ascending. Second one is the amount ascending as well. And the third one is the ID. And that one is ascending as well. So we are basically done. We just have to clean it up a bit. These two helper columns can go out. And this dates can become real dates. Yeah, and we can load. Close and load. And I will bring it to L1. That takes some time, but here we are, load to table, existing table, and existing worksheet, and I set L1. Here we are, looks all right, so it's good. Just let me quickly change here the formatting to using two decimals and a thousand separator. So this is exactly what we wanted. Hope you learned something, found it interesting, and until the next time.